Yeah, thank you. I'm a little bit late because I come from the cancer immunotherapy meeting in Mainz. It's always the case that ESHO and SIMT are overlapping, and this is a pity because we are dealing with immunotherapy here as well as in Mainz, so we should or join together or keep this meeting a little bit outside the Mainz meeting. But whatsoever, we work and have developed a global concept on immunotherapy using hyperthermia. I hope I find the pointer. Yes, using the hyperthermia to attack the tumor together with the oncolytic virus, Newcastle disease virus, with the idea, and it has been demonstrated here, that you indeed induce immunogenic cell death with all the hallmarks like calreticulin, ATP, heat shock proteins, and so on, thereby changing the intratumoral micromilieu so that dendritic cells become alarmed, pick up the material, move to the lymph nodes, and present tumor antigens, and in our case also viral antigens, to immune cells with the appropriate co-stimulatory signals so that these cells get activated and can go back to the tumor to fight the tumor. We also can use, besides whole tumor lysate, these antigenic extracellular microvesicles that are released in the blood, in fact liquid biopsy for therapy, to take them also for loading immature dendritic cells that are cultured out of monocytes with GM-CSF and IL-4. And then you have, of course, to mature these dendritic cells that are loaded with tumor antigens in the presence of cytokine cocktail, but we have also the approval to add here the oncolytic virus as a toll-like receptor stimulator for creating a highly mature dendritic cell that presents not only tumor antigens, but also the viral antigen. And this is an advanced therapy medicinal product which is approved and registered meanwhile as a vaccine to be injected back into the body again to stimulate immune cells for reaction against tumor antigens and for reaction against viral antigens. And then at the end, of course, you have to deal with checkpoint blockers, as already has been mentioned. This is the global concept, and of course, some quantification and online monitoring might be very interesting. And that is the question that I want to deal with you now. And we have in our laboratory an expert in TKTL1 and APO10 measurements. This protein is a blocker of apoptosis in tumor cells, and this is one of the hallmarks in cancer. And TKTL1 is a molecule that deals with carbohydrate fermentation in tumor cells, which is in fact the high metabolic rate, which makes the oncotherm specificity of tumor cells, because the conductivity is different due to the different metabolic activity in tumor cells. And then, of course, the question is, if we now combine with oncolytic virus and the hyperthermia, and we use here oncotherm, as you can see, even in children, this is very manageable treatment, and I have a poster on a lot of children treated with this oncotherm. So the question is, if we induce immunogenic cell death in these patients, can we then eventually monitor? And the answer, or the methodology, is that we try to measure within the circulating monocytes then fragments, TKTL1 and APO10, that are taken by the broken tumor cells into these monocytes. So here is a simplified cartoon. If we kill tumor cells over immunogenic cell death, then you have a release of tumor material in the periphery. And then the question is, will monocytes take up this material better, and can you measure this? And you can gate in the peripheral blood on CD14, CD16 positive cells, And then with an intracellular staining, you easily can measure the APO10 and the TKT1 positive intracellular staining in the CD14, CD16 positive cells. We have done that for a lot of brain tumor patients, and these are updated data. As you can see, most of these patients are glioblastoma at primary treatment or at time of relapse, but there are also quite a lot of DLPG, diffuse intrinsic pontine glioma children. So here are the children compartment, if you look to the age. And then indeed, we have treated these patients each time with 5 days of modulated electrohyperthermia and daily Newcastle disease virus injection, and a sixth time at the time when also the dendritic cell vaccine is given. This is one vaccination cycle, and then 3 weeks later we give a second vaccination cycle. Again, 5 days modulated electrohyperthermia, Newcastle disease virus, and a sixth time at time of the dendritic cell vaccine at day 8 of the vaccination cycle. And what you can see here is for a first vaccination cycle, for a second vaccination cycle, the increase on a day-by-day basis of the TKT1 and of the APO10 and of the sum of TKT1 and APO10. And here you see the significance, and as you can see, each time we had a highly significant increase measured day by day upon the effect of Newcastle disease virus and hyperthermia. And here you can see patients that could be followed for a first vaccination cycle, then there is an interval of 3 weeks, and we followed the patients then also for a second vaccination cycle. And as you can see, the effect is disappeared after 3 weeks and comes back again. So it is really a treatment-mediated effect which fits also in time. So that means, and that is the message that I want to give to you for all who works with immunogenic cell death concepts, this is in fact an easy tool. 2 milliliters of blood you only need to do this intracellular staining, and you can use these kits with the PanTum tests to measure in the CD40, CD16 positive population on a day-by-day basis the effect what you have created. So this whole complex is only part of the game. So what we think at the moment is that we have for GBM at least not only the surgery, the radiochemotherapy, the chemotherapy, also target therapy and targeted immunotherapy. These are in fact the checkpoint blockers, but also biology therapy, the Newcastle disease virus, and physics therapy, the Optune, which is in fact a long-run oncotherm device. Both are based on modulated electrohyperthermia. They all can be designed in a way to induce immunogenic cell death, but it might still be needed that you also have to induce an active specific immunotherapy with vaccines to get at the end an active specific immunization in the body. And this is maybe then a major step forward for the patient towards potential cure or at least long-term overall survival. And the personalization of this medicine is not only at the molecular biology, for instance, MGMT methylation, but also at the tumor antigens, the tumor host interaction, the treatment combinations in the appropriate way, and the response to treatment, as I have shown you now. Maybe we have not only to induce and measure ICD, but we have also to put a target to get enough ICD to proceed. And that's in fact what is important and which is elaborated in our center in a combined approach, having GMP laboratory activities connected to clinical activities. And just to announce and celebrate, we will open 8 new clean rooms because we have increasing work, and we will also celebrate the fact that we have a new EU project in event, so you are all invited eventually to come to this single day symposium on glioblastoma immunotherapy at the 6th September 2019. I thank you.
Thank you very much for this clear update and also for this important immune biomarker as we discussed before. Are there questions? Yes, please.
Thank you for the presentation. It's very interesting for me. Maybe I missed it. Do you have side effects from the treatments to the brain? And do you need steroids or do you administer any other medication in combination with it?
The answer is very simply no. We, however, are moderate. So most of these patients have been treated with 40 watts, adults for 50 minutes, children for 40 minutes. However, I think based on the data and also what I will show in the poster that, for instance, for the DIPG part, where the tumor is very deep located, that the 40 watts was not enough because with this biomarker, we see the increase less going up. So the new children that come now, they have an increased treatment up to 60 watts. And also this is perfectly manageable without any problem because the device is a very handy device to use. So now we move to 60 watts, 50 minutes in adults, 40 minutes in children, and that can be done without major issues, in fact, and no side effects.
Yes, I have a question. So thank you for your presentation. And you made a comparison to the Optune device, which is working at 250 kilohertz, a clear different frequency. And
yes,
as far as I know and understand the method, it's a completely different physical interaction because it's acting on the non-completing of the cell division, which is completely different than electrothermia.
Well, I have discussed with the people from Optune quite in depth, and I was very surprised about their message in the last SNOW meeting in New Orleans, that in fact Optune does not give a good effect if the patient has dexamethasone more than 4 milligrams. So that means to me that at least a part of the Optune effect is using the immune system. So that means for me that part of the effect is also the induction of immunogenic cell death. I'm fully aware that the frequency and the goal of Optune is completely different,
right,
as the modulated electrohyperthermia. But that does not mean that Optune should also count on immunotherapeutic effects on the change of the microenvironment. And that was what I wanted to say.
Okay, well, that's clear, because we have to be careful not confusing different methods.
Sure.
And if the physical activity is different, then we should state that clearly, and that they have in the end a different or a similar biological effect
sure,
or immunological effect, that's fine with me.
And even elaborating further on that, I have also asked, and I don't know the answer, and obviously the Optune people also do not know the answer. I have asked if you block your GBM tumor cell proliferation and you bring the cells into a cell arrest, and using at the same time temozolomide, which counts on cell proliferation to have the effect, how should you understand the combination? And that seemed to me quite unlogic given the simple Optune temozolomide combination. And even Roger Stoop could not completely answer this question. So the more I was starting to thinking that maybe the effect is the cell arrest as such, but also the immune effect on top of that.
Okay, thank you very much. I think